rules and regulations that they had in the past. The Indian people and the chiefs made sure that all the people are being treated the same. No one is better than the other. And we prayed for the animal that we could go hunting, like this buffalo. We're going to go hunting buffalo. We always have a ceremony to bless the animal that they're going to kill, so it's being prayed for. They prayed for before they killed it. And only what we needed for the size of each of the village, families of the village. We only kill what they needed, what they need. No more. We don't. And they have contests over if a man kills a buffalo with one arrow, he's a good hunter. If he kills a buffalo with two or three arrows, he's a poor hunter. Those kind of contests they always have amongst each other. And we use every bit of the buffalo. Horns even, the nails, bones, everything out of them. Made something out of horns, ribs, or knives, and everything. So that's. And for small animals, if we have to hunt for small animals or birds, they still pray for the birds and animals that they're going to kill. And they always also protect insects. Because everything has a right to them and their being. One insect protects another. It protects the trees, plants, one insect to another. They all have a place in life. Everything. These animals are to be wild. They never get tamed. They're left wild. And mind you, the Indians don't eat any animal that is not a vegetarian. Animals that eat meat, they eat them alone. But the animals that are vegetarians, those are the ones that can be used for food. Especially this animal. Not a medicine. That animal in this never got sick. It didn't have diseases or anything. There's a lot of things that I have to tell you that the past lived evenly with animals, insects, birds, fish, and they're even as they are. They don't make room for human beings. But human beings are the ones that really mess things up. They get over. Right now they're poking you on one side. So you go on.